U.S. Secretary of State John Kerry is warning of significant differences between Iran and six world powers working on an agreement that would stop expansion of nuclear activities that could be used to make weapons. The talks come as Iran celebrated the anniversary of the November 1979 takeover of the U.S. Embassy. 52 Americans were held hostage for 444 days. Ambassador John Limbert was one of them. His foreign service included tours in Algeria, Djibouti, Saudi Arabia, the United Arab Emirates, and Iran. I talked to him this week about the hostage crisis and U.S. relations with Iran. Ambassador Limbert, the hostage crisis anniversary was marked by demonstrations in Iran. What do those demonstrations tell us about the state of politics in Iran right now?
I mean, you can read them in different ways. I would like to read them as kind of a last gasp of the ideologues to say, okay, we're still here. You have to deal with us. We're a force to be reckoned with. But frankly, events are passing them by, and it looks like things are changing in Iran. And there's a new spirit. People talk of moderation. People, even the supreme leader, talks about heroic flexibility, which is another word for moderation. So I think things are changing. But anytime things change, there's always going to be a group that wants to hold on to the old way. So I call it the last hurrah.
So if things are changing, how serious is the threat posed by Iran in the region and to the U.S.?
My own view is that the talk of the Iranian threat to us or to our allies has always been overblown. It's not a regime that we like. It does things that we do not like. But its ability to threaten us or threaten our friends, frankly, is quite limited.
How would you characterize U.S.-Iranian relations now compared to 34 years ago?
Well, 34 years ago, until April of 1980, officially, we had relations. I mean, the relations existed between the two countries, and the officials from the two countries could talk to each other. For 34 years, they were in a deep freeze. There were almost no exchanges, and what exchanges they were. Basically, threats and insults and name calling, and sometimes worse. It was an estrangement, 34 years long. That within the last couple of months, since the election of President Rouhani and the changes that have followed that in Iran, things seem to be changing, and perhaps that long freeze is finally thawing out.
John, looking at the recent events in Benghazi, what does that tell us about the safety of the diplomats around the world? Has it gotten better or worse?
It's a good question. It's probably no better. We live in a world in a very dangerous world, and our diplomats, very often, my colleagues, they go to difficult places. They go to dangerous places because it's important that we be represented there. On the other hand, there are times like Tehran 34 years ago, or Benghazi last September 11th, where frankly we probably shouldn't be, or shouldn't be at least in the numbers that we are, and maybe where the situation is simply too dangerous.
You don't see the U.S. and Iran being endless enemies, do you?
No, we didn't talk to the Soviets for about almost 20 years after their revolution. We didn't talk to the Chinese for a little over 20 years after their revolution. But eventually, we established relations with Moscow. President Nixon went to China, and we established relations. 34 years is a long time for estrangement. But in politics, nothing is forever. Nothing is forever. I think if you listen to what the Iranians say, even some of the more ideological ones, even they admit that this may not be forever and that the situation could change.
Ambassador John Limbert, thank you for joining us.
You're quite welcome, Dick. My pleasure.